In the last lesson, I talked about how find and replace works in one file. In this lesson, I want to talk about how you can search across multiple files efficiently. I'm not working in my little project for this because I want to show you how it works on something that has lots of files. The project folder I'm in has many node modules installed and also a decent number of project files in the JS app directory. I'm not going to talk about shortcuts too much in this video because I did that in the last lesson. Remember, you can always just go up to the Find menu to see the shortcuts on your operating system. What I want to focus on instead is how to efficiently search for something across many files. In a folder with lots of files, searching across the entire project can be fairly slow, so it's good to know how to narrow down that search. To search across multiple files, you just add the Shift key to the Find shortcut. When I do that, it brings up the Find and Files panel, which is very similar to the regular Find panel. The difference is that it tells me what I'm searching inside of right here where it says In Project. Then I have this drop-down box where it tells me no files will be excluded. If I search for a word that will have a lot of matches like function, you can see that it takes a moment to give me the list because it's searching the entire project. We can see it found many matches, but I don't really want to look at them all. One very efficient way to narrow my search is to just search in one folder. If I really only want to look in my app directory and not the entire project, I can go to that folder in the sidebar, right-click, and choose Find In. Now it's only looking in the JS app directory, and the search returns very quickly. It only shows 100 matches at one time, and you can navigate through the list as you would guess with these arrows. You can also collapse the matches in a file. This is a very efficient method of finding things when it works, but sometimes you want to search across multiple folders. That's when you'll want to set up exclusion sets. If I do a Find in Files, I can click on the button on the right. Then I can click on New Exclusion Set. It helps to read what it says here. It will exclude any files and folders that match the strings you type in. There's a link also that you might want to click on so you can read in more detail how it works. Before I type anything, look at this line at the bottom. It's telling me it will currently search through 6,831 files in the project. I don't want to look through node modules. If I type node modules, it will now only search through 78 files. That is quite a difference. Also notice that if I backspace and erase the word modules, the file number stays the same. That's because just typing node will exclude everything in the node modules directory. You don't need to type the entire folder name. It just needs a match. What brackets does is change your filters to really be double asterisk, node, double asterisk. So it ends up excluding any file or folder that has the word node in it. If I typed module instead of node, I have different results because I do actually have some application code in a subdirectory called modules. So only node works here. I also have a subdirectory called generated where all the CSS and JavaScript gets generated into one file. I normally wouldn't want to search here either, so I'll add generated on the next line. Notice the file count goes down to 74. You should not put a comma in your list, just type the next string on a new line. I can give this set a name, or brackets will name it for me when I click on OK. Now when I do a search, the results are returned to me much faster. If we look at the exclusion sets, we can see brackets named it node, comma, generated. This file right here, generated-tests.js, is not an important file actually and should be deleted, but I want to keep it to point out something that might not be clear yet. We can see the word factory right here in the file. If I do a regular find just in this file, we can see there are 16 instances of the word factory. If I search across files in my exclusion set, it found the word factory in 5 files. If I collapse all the files, I don't see this generated test.js file anywhere. That's because excluding the generated folder with the word generated also excludes any files that have the word generated in them. This idea was confusing to me in the beginning, and I didn't realize I was excluding more than I really wanted with some of my lists. We can see all of these files are in the vendor directory. I'll create a new exclusion set that includes vendor also. I'm going to stick to the keyboard this time, so I'll tab over to the button and hit enter. Then arrow down to New Exclusion Set and hit Enter again. I'll call this one All since I'm excluding almost everything except the source code. I have to hit Shift plus Tab to get back to the entry field before I can hit Enter to make the find run. Notice that it didn't find any matches. When that happens, you get the pink box around the text input, and it tells me there were no results. To do a replace across files, it will work in a similar way to what I discussed in the last lesson. Let's say I wanted to create a sales app that's similar to rentals, and I want to use that module as a starting point for my code because they'll be so similar. I can find and then copy the rentals folder to something named sales. Then rename the app file. Then I can do some find and replace across the sales folder. I'll right-click on sales and then choose Replace In. I don't need to exclude anything because I already narrowed down my search to the folder. I do want to match case, and I will replace rentals app with sales app and click on Replace. The one thing that's new when you do this across multiple files is that you can uncheck either an instance of the word or you can uncheck a file. You could also toggle them all off up here and then turn on some individually. I do want to replace all this time. After I hit replace, it's updated all the instances and opened all three files. Notice none of them are saved. So I could actually undo any of the changes in a file if I changed my mind. If I want them all, I can just do a save all and they will all get saved at once. If you end up replacing something in more than 20 files, brackets will warn you that it will save them all and you can't undo. It does this for performance reasons. So the find and replace across files is very useful, but it helps to know how to only look at the files you want. If you only want to target a specific folder, that is often the best way to narrow down the search. If you need to go across multiple folders, then using the exclusion sets can help. In the next lesson, I'll talk about the feature that allowed me to make brackets my full-time editor, and that's multiple cursors.